this was a very atypical type of a meningioma. Meningiomas are benign tumors, meaning that they don't metastasize or anything like that. However, you know, it's extremely rare to see a tumor grow this large and through the skull base and into the nose and the sinuses.
This is an incredibly complicated and challenging case, and it really requires a multi-team approach to be successful in something like this. You really have to have multiple specialties all pulling in the same direction to make this a reality.
So Mr. DeHart had an incredibly challenging problem. He had this very large tumor, almost the size of a grapefruit, in the front of his head, displacing his brain far backwards, producing tremendous amount of swelling, which in and of itself would be enough. But the tumor then grew down through the base of the skull into the nose. And literally you could look inside of his nose and you could see the tumor growing down.
And so previously, when we would try to remove these big tumors in this area, it was very difficult because the problem with resecting something that large is how do you fix the big hole that we make, okay? Especially if a tumor is very large and we have to resect the entire skull base. Clearly, there's a lot of bacteria that reside in the nose and the sinuses. And if we can't create a vascularized, you know, stable, secure barrier between the brain and the nose, the patient's gonna have massive complications such as meningitis and possibly may die. And so figuring out that component of how do you reconstruct a large defect that we make is one piece of the puzzle.
To successfully remove that, it would require both the neurosurgeons working from the top down and the otolaryngologist working from the bottom up to clear the tumor. The problem is, once the tumor is removed, now you've created a tunnel or a space that's joining the mouth and the nose to the brain.
You've got a hole maybe about this big, which brain fluid's gonna leak through, brain's gonna leak through. So how do you fix that? What do you do to put it all back together again?
And so what we did is we employed a technique called microsurgery. And we actually borrowed a segment of expendable muscle from the side of the thigh, along with its nutrient blood vessels. It has one dominant artery that comes into it and another dominant vein that drains the blood out of that tissue. We placed it in the base of the skull to separate the mouth again from the brain. And we took its blood vessels and connected them to blood vessels in front of the ear, artery to artery, vein to vein, under a microscope with stitches about the third the diameter of a human hair. And so that allows for restoration of circulation through that tissue so it can live in the new location. It's a transplant essentially, but it's your own material, so you don't have to take medication to prevent rejection.
So we used all kinds of things that weren't even available 5 or 10 years ago. We used virtual reality, where we can actually touch any spot in the brain and skull and see where we are within 1 millimeter accuracy on the MRI. We used something called surgical theater, where you put an Oculus Rift helmet on and you literally fly in virtual reality through the brain. You can turn around, you can say, where's the vessels, where's this? That wasn't something we had 5 years ago.
We will come back at a later state, probably in a couple of months, and again, employ some new technology with a 3D printed scaffold to replace the missing bone in the frontal bar area. In these complex cases now, we're really starting to utilize a lot of computer-assisted design, computer-assisted modeling in conjunction with our virtual reality approaches, and they are really helping us take on these big challenges.
The nice thing about here at Houston Methodist Hospital is that, you know, being a tertiary and quaternary referral center, we see a lot of very complex, difficult problems. And this was definitely, you know, one of the top that we've seen as of late. But that being said, you know, the collaborative nature of our expertise really enables us to push the boundaries of what we could do. 5 years ago, we couldn't do a case like this, like we did. And now we can.